microplastics aren't going anywhere, and we can't wait until we have all the pieces to do the big studies. We are consuming microplastics even though we don't know it always. We know it at least in theory, but we don't see the microplastics in our food, but they are in our food. And so anything that's in our food, in the things that we drink, sooner or later is going to make it into our digestive system and our colon. So we're really interested in trying to understand how those microplastics might be impacting our experiences with colorectal cancer. We thought in particular about early onset colorectal cancer, knowing that young people today are exposed throughout their lifetime to much higher levels of plastics than people who were younger 20, 30, 40 years ago. And so our goal then was to try and figure out if the burden of microplastics is different for people with early versus later onset colorectal cancers. Could we even find those microplastics in tumors? And that's something that we've just recently received some funding from the National Cancer Institute, which is part of the National Institutes of Health. We're at a really important time in history to be looking at this question. It's important for us to do right now the work that will lay the foundation for future studies, helping us to better understand the impact of microplastics.